What's up, y'all? Kyle here. You're watching Driving and Vibing. Today, I am excited to be sharing 7 of the best free campsites in the state of Texas. So stay tuned. Welcome back to the channel, y'all. Thank you so much for joining me here today. So today's video is all about free camping in Texas. And while it is one of the biggest states in the nation, it doesn't have that much free camping relative to its size. So we want to point out 7 of the best free campsites in the state of Texas. Most of these are plopped right on some beautiful body of water, and they're great sites. So if at any time in this video we're going through the information too quickly and you want to reference this for later, I'll link the article in the description so you can have that information bookmarked whenever you travel to Texas. And also, I ask you to share your favorite Texas free campsite with us in case we missed one. So without any further ado, let's hop in, starting at number 7, and that's Shriner City Park in Junction, Texas. One reason we love Shriner City Park so much is that it's unique because it's a city park located about 100 yards to the main strip of downtown. Junction might not be a big city, but it is awesome to be able to camp right on the water and be able to walk downtown to the restaurants, the little shops, or just for a nice scenic exercising break. Shriner City Park is great for that. They also have some disc golf on the park. They have a few ball fields there, and they have water spigots available for you to fill up, although there aren't really any other amenities on site. It is dry camping, so you can just choose your spot along the river and get situated. We've seen every size rig here, from big motorhomes, fifth wheels, and travel trailers and vans. Any size rig can fit, but the smaller the rig, the more epic of a sight you can get right on the waterfront. You don't have to take our word for it though. Here is what Life Trekking says on Campendium. They say this is a great little park. These are free sites to just pull in by the sides of the park. Some are in trees, some are in the open. There are a few playgrounds, a river you can swim in, a pool with shower facilities that are open during the summer and only cost $2. So there you have it. Shriner City Park, number 7. Let's move on to number 6. Fort Anahuac Park in Fort Anahuac, Texas. Now, this is another city park, and they offer waterfront sites as well. One of the best activities at the Fort Anahuac Park is fishing. They have a pier located down at the bottom of the park where you can go fishing too. So if you love to camp and fish, Fort Anahuac Park is pretty awesome. One thing about Fort Anahuac Park is that although all size rigs can fit there, if you're camping there during normal business hours during the week, they want you to go get a free permit at the city hall. It's just a few blocks away. The process took us about 90 seconds once we got there, so all they want is a copy of your driver's license. And if you pull in on like a Saturday night and you only plan to overnight park, we've heard that it's really not essential to have one of these to camp there, but they just like to follow protocol and make sure no one's overstaying their limits. So it's another dry camping spot. You're gonna have to bring all the stuff you need, but we totally recommend it if you want some waterfront camping in Texas and fishing. You can't beat it. Number 5 on our list is Fritch Fortress Campground. This is located on Lake Meredith, Texas. And while it's not literally waterfront camping, you do get a beautiful, picturesque view of Lake Meredith sitting atop a large cliff. This free campground sets you up on a beautiful overlook of Lake Meredith, where you can then drive down and recreate on the lake. But one of the cool things about this campground is that it's really just a paved loop with camp pull-offs. So everything is kind of like essentially a pull-through slash pull-off. And it has a bathroom on site that has hot showers and clean toilets. So I'm not arguing with either of those two things when I'm at a free campsite. It's pretty awesome because they also have lots of covered pavilions, picnic tables, and grills. We totally recommend this. And hey, one of our favorite YouTubers, Technomadia, on their Campendium post says, this spot has been one of our favorites over our years on the road. It hits the Technomadia trifecta: free, scenic, and excellent cellular signal. Thanks, Technomadia, for reviewing it on Campendium. As you guys know, Campendium is our favorite spot to find free campsites. So we recommend checking it out. Fritch Fortress Campground, right on Lake Meredith, Texas. Coming in at number 4 on our list is one of the most popular sites in Texas among free camping RVers, and that is Magnolia Beach City Park. It is a beautiful waterfront site right on a bay. It's right outside of Port Lavaca, Texas. It doesn't have direct Gulf of Mexico access, which is good in our opinion because the tide fluctuations are less dramatic, meaning you don't have to pay as close of attention to if the tide's gonna wash your rig away. And it's not as intense saltwater winds blowing on you. So both of those reasons, we really like the vibe of Magnolia Beach. It's also packed sand and rock. You can easily drive on it. We've seen motorhomes, we've seen big fifth wheels there. Every type of camper we've seen been able to park on Magnolia Beach. The big upside of this is that they have a beautiful bathhouse with hot showers, picnic areas. But I have to say the downside of Magnolia Beach is that it's not well monitored. So they don't really have stay limits posted. No one in our experience has come around and checked on stay limits, which seems like it can be a benefit if you don't want to be bothered, but it also breeds an attitude of full-time camping there. So some people have turned Magnolia Beach more into a home base, and that ends up always working in the worst interest for RVers in general. So we recommend you not overstay your welcome there. Enjoy the beach, but also move on and don't set up home. If you've camped at Magnolia Beach, let us know, because it is super popular. We've loved the experience there and recommend anyone who wants to do some beach camping to check out Magnolia Beach as a good introduction to beach camping. Because number 3 on our list, North Beach on the Padre Island National Seashore, is a dramatic difference from Magnolia Beach. We loved the North Beach here on Padre Island, but it was the most intense beach camping that we have ever done throughout our camping journey. The wind was always blowing, salt ruined everything. It rusted the truck and the camper. We washed it immediately after, but you gotta deal with the salt. And the sun beats down on you. So one of my bucket list items was to do beach camping, and this really fulfilled that for me. And I'd recommend anyone who wants to camp on white sandy beaches to try it out. But you got to be observant of the salt. You got to be super observant of the tides changing. Every year, rigs get washed away in the tide, and it costs thousands of dollars to recover them. So you have to always be monitoring the situation and doing your research. The payoff is awesome because you get to camp on a white sandy beach, but it doesn't come without some concerns. Don't take our word for it though. Big Travel's Tiny Home on Campendium says this boondocking spot was absolutely amazing. This is a must-stay spot if you are in Texas. It is dog friendly, which our dog loved. There is a lot of wildlife. We only had one other camper join us on the beach, and it was only for 2 nights. So there you have it. One of our favorite of all the free camping spots in Texas is North Beach on Padre Island. Check it out. Number 2 on our list is Bolivar Flats Free Beach. This one is very, very similar to North Beach, which we just talked about, insofar as it's beautiful sandy beaches you're camping on. You gotta pay attention to the tides. But the one thing we really like about Bolivar Flats is that you don't have to drive all the way down to Padre Island to do this type of beach camping. This is located on Bolivar Peninsula, which is right outside of Galveston, Texas. So a larger population of Texas has much more easy access to this campsite. So that's one reason why we ranked it a little bit higher than North Beach and really like it, because more people can access it more easily close to home. If you're in the area, we totally recommend you checking it out, but make sure you keep an eye on the tide, because we don't want you to end up in the Gulf of Mexico. That would not be a good thing. So Mrs. Brent on Campendium says about Bolivar Flats, it's such a unique experience to camp directly on the beach. We stopped at the big store on our way in and got a $10 permit to park on the beach, and it's good until the end of the year. The sand is very packed down, making the access in a travel trailer doable. We have a 30-foot travel trailer and didn't have any issues hauling or parking. Great to hear that first-hand experience. Thank you for using Campendium for those reviews again. Number 1 on our list of free camping in Texas is a unique option. And I wouldn't even say it's the most beautiful, but it is a great place to recharge your batteries. We say it's a great place to recharge your batteries because it is literally and figuratively. You have free electric and water at this city park. So not only is it free camping, but you can have access to electricity at the campsite, which means if it's a little too hot, you can run that AC, or if your batteries need to be topped off, you can charge them up. Super cool that Silverton Municipal Park provides this. We've seen this provided a lot out in the western states like Wyoming, maybe Montana. It's not really a common thing in Texas. Angela on Campendium says you can walk across the street and eat at Something Different by Kay. And there are a couple of small restaurants in town, lovely courthouse and library, one gas station. So if you're just looking for something different in Texas and want to pull your camper for a weekend trip and still have electricity, check out Silverton Municipal Park. Very cool option in the state of Texas. Now that wraps up hour 7, but remember, please, if we missed one, tell us in the comments section. We're always looking for the best free campsites in the country. And primarily, Texas is a great place to do camping. It's one of our favorite states, especially in the winter months. Check that article out if you need to reference this for your travels coming up in the future. We'll link it, like I said, in the description and in the comment section. Easy to access for you. And thank you guys for tuning in today. We will see you soon. Later on.